That was a clip from the new documentary, Until They Are Home. It chronicles the search for the remains of U.S. Marines killed in the Battle of Tarawa during World War II. Joining me from Los Angeles to tell us about the unsung heroes behind the search is filmmaker Stephen Barber. He's director of Until They Are Home. Who are the people that are searching for these remains?
They are some of the greatest human beings and patriots that the country's ever produced. It's called JPAC. It's an acronym for the Joint POW-MIA County Command, and it's made up of our Air Force, our Navy, our Marines, and all of our service people. Based out of Hickam Air Force Base, they go around the world circumventing the globe looking for our fallen 88,000 missing from World War II. It's staggering. And they're just a great group of folks, and I got to embed with them for about 41 days in the battle site of Tarawa, which is about the size of Central Park, and it has 50,000 people living on it, so it's quite a challenge to look for some of the 300, 400, 500 men that are still missing.
When you first got to Tarawa, what was your reaction?
When I first got there, it was an absolute third-world cesspool. I was like, couldn't believe it. There were diapers, defecation, I mean, garbage everywhere, all over the beaches. It was horrific. So it was barely recognizable as a battle site until you get out into the reef and you find bullet casings. There's tanks still in there. There's still live bombs. We went through the South Pacific rather quickly, you know, in 3 years. We never went back and cleaned it up. I mean, it's just, it's horrific out there.
So I don't understand how there could still be remains. Why didn't the military try and bring them home years ago?
The question, why? You know what? They stopped repatriating in about 1948. That's kind of, I don't know why. You know, I think it was the Truman administration said, you know, happy days are here again. Let's move on. But to the 88,000 family members, that was never the case. And I've just been really fortunate to be part of this. And it's a very expensive process. I mean, JPAC has a very limited budget. They bring home about 100 people a year. But it's really not about the dead, you know, it's about the living. It's about, and the sorrow is passed on from generation to generation. And it's really quite moving.